Hey guys, welcome back to our second tutorial video, and that is the world map overview video. Now, we just started a new campaign as a band of mercenaries, and we just take a look around at the world. Now, as you can see, the world map is revealed around all the human settlements, and you can see already quite a bit. Now, from the very south that we have here, that is covered in desert, thanks to the new Southern Deserts DLC. You will not have this in the base game. And the dry steppe lands, the green valleys. Then we have swamps, we have autumn woods, we have dark woods, mountains, of course, hills. And now as we get further to the north, we have tundra and this very snowy north in the on the top of the map. We can take a closer look, for example, at this settlement here that is governed by a noble house, and as you can see by the banner of it. And this world map is procedurally generated, so each time you start a new campaign, this will look completely different, and also the names and the banners of the noble houses will be different, and everything about the world will change. So the location of bodies of water, the location of any terrain type, the settlements themselves, the size of the settlement, the goods that the settlement will produce, the hidden locations throughout the map, everything will be randomized. So when you start a new campaign and you really like the map that you're playing, you can copy the map seed and then you can start the game on that very same map. Now, let's take a closer look at one of the settlements over here. So depending on the location of a settlement, there are various attached locations. For example, Hakenstadt over here has a workshop that's typical for a city that's close to the mountains, and there they produce tools. Now, other settlements like Weidefield, they are sitting on fertile land, and for example, this town has an orchard, and this means that in the town you will most likely be able to purchase fruit to feed your men. So this is just a very small glimpse of the economics that are going on here, and we don't want to get into that on too much detail right now. So what I will do now is that we quickly go through the user interface, and I will explain what to look out for. Now on the very top left, this is most important. This is your crowns, this is your money. You're losing it daily as you have to pay wages for your men. The mercenaries are not fighting for free. And you will mainly earn money through fulfilling contracts. So settlements will hire you for a short amount of time and will pay you when you fulfill their contracts. Now you have food. Your men also need to eat. That you can buy these in settlements as well. Then you have tools and supplies. They are used to repair all your arms and armor. Ammunition will refill all your quivers and your ranged weapons. And then you have medical supplies, and these are used to heal the lost hit points of your men and heal injuries as well. So all of these can be restocked in settlements if the settlement offers the according good. Now here we have the date and time. This is the first day in the morning, and this will slowly, when I unpause the game, this will slowly move ahead. And we can fast forward it a little bit faster. And here you can see we are approaching midday, and you can also stop the game here. Now this is the roster. This is one of the core parts that we will look into in a second. Now we can center the camera on our band of mercenaries. We can just move around over here. We can lock the camera to the character. We can toggle footprints. So when a party on the world map travels around, it leaves footprints that you can see. So you can distinguish between, for example, beasts and humans, and the size of the footprints gives the size of the party that came by. That way you can follow other parties. You can camp. This will set up a camp where you repair and heal more quickly and time passes quickly. Then we have the retinue. This is a new feature that we added with the Blazing Deserts DLC, and we will look into that in a second. And the obituary. So when one of your brothers gets killed, you will see the name here, the number of days they have been with your company, how many battles and kills they had, and how they demised. And finally, we can take a look at your relations with different factions, for example, the House Berengar or the House Volsach. And these are the leaders of this noble house. Here we also have the renown. So right now you start out as a completely unknown and unprofessional band of small-time warriors. And at some point, everybody will know your name, depending on the deeds that you do and the battles that you fight. So this is a very, very short overview of the UI of the world map and the background. And now let's take a quick peek at the management of your roster. So this is the core part where you manage your actual fighters in the game. Here you can see your band of battle brothers. You start out usually with three. Different origins will have a different amount of fighters. And here you can see the state, the equipment, and everything else, all the vital information that you need on your bros. Now, on the lower left are all the stats that we have. We will look into this in the next video. And here you can also equip your men, and you can see your provisions, like your food supply, for example. Now, we will look into this, as I said, in the next video. And we quickly take a glance at this new DLC feature. It's called the Retinue. Now, here you can unlock a couple of non-combat followers. Those are people who aid you in your journeys and who are not fighting for you. For example, you can hire a cook or a blacksmith that helps in repairing arms and armors. Now, to end this video, we want to take a look at the settlement screen. So let's go into this town over here and take a look at the goods and services that this offers. Now, as you can see here, this town has a different set of buildings over here, and each building has a different functionality. For example, at the market, this is where you usually want to go first. You can buy all kinds of provisions and cheap arms and armor. Another important building is the tavern, where you can go to spend some crowns on increasing the mood of your men or to pick up some rumors. Now, we will leave it at this for the moment, for this video, because we don't want to make those too long. And I see you in a bit in the World Map First Steps video that is coming up next.